Chapter 9, Public Facilities. In this chapter, we will be discussing what are public facilities. We all know that a facility which is provided to the public by the government is known as public facility. Why we say that only government is responsible to provide the facilities to the public? As we know, the definition of democracy, it describes that the government works for the people, which is elected by the people in order to serve the needs of the people. In this process, the first utmost duty of the government is to ensure all the basic requirements of the people are fulfilled properly. If you look at the definition of Jeremy Bentham's will, where he describes that in his book, government is nothing but it starts to take care from before you are born to after your death. How is it possible? Before you are born, you are in the mother's womb. When you are in the mother's womb itself, by providing proper treatment to your mother, the responsibility of the government will start, and it ends after your death. Your dead body has to be taken care properly. It has to be buried or it has to be burned. So all this means before you are born to after your death, from womb to tomb, everything is the responsibility of the representative governments. That's what he mentioned in his book. So nowadays, if you look at the democratic governments, these democratic governments are responsible governments. Their main duty is to cater the needs of the people. Now, moving into details for us, in Chennai, water, how is the water available to the people of Chennai? Is it available equally to all sections of people in all areas or not? Let us see here. Mr. Ram Gopal, he is a government servant. He stays in the Nagar called Anna Nagar, which is lushly green in color, where the water tankers come and sprinkle the water and make the gardens look very green, and the flowers will be present on the trees. So Mr. Ram Gopal is not having any problem with the supply of water. Most part of the day in their bungalows, the water will be running through the taps. Once in a while, the taps will be stopped, or one day in a week, there may be some water problem. Then Mr. Ram Gopal calls to some of his friends, or one of his friend who is in the municipal department, and ensures that he gets a water tank for him. When it comes to Subramaniam's, Mr. Subramaniam stays at a place called Mylapore. In this place, most of the people depend on bore wells because they don't get much access to the government supply of the water. Very rarely they get water here, and these bore wells will be fulfilling the needs. But the basic problem is this bore well water is brackish and it is not nice or suitable to drink because it may cause many diseases. That is why they all collect this bore water and they have installed the purification water filters in their houses. So they use the water filters and drink that water. The rest of the water they will be using for cleaning or washing the clothes, like that. And moving to the other place where Shiva stays, at Madipakam. In Madipakam, they get water once in every 4 days. So initially we were talking about Ram Gopal's Anna Nagar, where water is supplied whole along the week without any problem. When it comes to Mylapore, where Subramanian's apartment was there, where they depend largely on the bore wells, and the underground water is brackish water, and they have installed the filters for them to drink the water because they don't have any supply of the government water coming here. When it comes to Shiva's place, that is Madipakam, in Madipakam they get water once in every 4 days. And last, Padma, who is a domestic maid, gets water. She stays at Saidapet and she gets water 20 minutes per day twice, that is morning 20 minutes and evening 20 minutes. They does not have their own tap. The entire, she stays, she is a domestic maid, so she will be getting a salary of rupees 650 around, and she will be staying in the outskirts of the city. And for 30 houses, they don't have proper washrooms or they don't have proper water supply for them. They depend on the borewell. That borewell water will be supplied for them for 20 minutes in a morning 20 and evening 20 minutes. Each family will be getting only 3 buckets. There are nearly 30 families who depend on the water which is brought here. So like this, this is the availability of the water in the city of Chennai. Water as a fundamental right. If you look, what is a necessity for us to have water? Water is very much essential for us in our day-to-day life. Without water, we cannot lead our life. How we require air? After air, the most important what we require is water, which gives life for us and also gives good health. If you drink water, you will have good health. Daily needs, like starting from as soon as we get up, we start to brush our teeth, we need water. So for our physical needs, then at the household requirements, for washing the utensils, for cooking, everything, washing clothes, cleaning of the houses, cleaning of everything, we need water. And after fulfilling our daily needs, if we have good access to water, that is, if we are able to have good water which is not having any contaminated diseases, then you can prevent water related diseases like diarrhea, cholera, dysentery. There are people who die because of the infections which they get due to these diseases. Like 1600 people in our country, especially the children less than 5 years of age, are passing every day. That is really a very high number due to lack of proper drinking water for them. They are affected with dysentery, diarrhea. So all these diseases can be prevented if they are having access to good or safe water to them. If they are getting access to pure drinking water, these 1600 people's life can be saved. And moving on to Article 21, as per the constitutional clause, right to life is Article 21's main theme here. According to this article, right to life guarantees for you to live comfortably. So according to this, what is the basic requirement for you to live? That is water. Water should be having universal access. You should have free hand to use the water. And in 2007 also, the Supreme Court as well as the AP state has restated the same thing, stating that water is the most important element in every human's life, where we need water sufficiently. When there was a letter written to AP High Court by Mehboob Nagar villagers stating that the textile industry has been draining out the pollutants into the drinking water river and spoiling the entire drinking water, and with this they are getting various diseases, immediately the court responded and gave orders to the district collector of Mehboob Nagar, stating that every villager should get at least 25 liters of water per day. This water has to be supplied on the responsibility of government, and collector has to make sure that this water reaches to the people. Like this, the constitution as well as the court have upheld the rights of the citizens to have access to water. In our country, the importance of water is not much known. One is, those who know the importance of water are having access to good supply of water. Those who are rich are in the capacity to buy the water if necessary, or influential to get the water. But when it comes to the poverty stricken people or below poverty line people, it is very, very difficult for them to get access to drinking water So like this is the right now situation of our country. We need to ensure that water is supplied sufficiently to all the people, then we can easily prevent the deaths of nearly 1600 people, especially the children less than 5 years of age, who are not able to get access to pure drinking water. If you provide good drinking water for them, these many people do not die. These are the only statistics. We don't know how many people are really suffering, not only the children, the old aged people. Any age, we need good supply of water. Then only we can lead a healthy life. Otherwise, we will be infected by the diseases like cholera, diarrhea, and dysentery, and sometimes we may lose our lives also. Public facilities. As we are discussing wholly, as the title of the lesson itself dictates, that we are discussing about the public facilities. The facilities which are once provided to the society can be utilized by n number of people, which will be taken care by the government. Once if you establish a school, it can be established by any individual with the motto of giving education to the children of the society. After certain years, the government takes the responsibility of running the school and ensures that the school runs efficiently and effectively for the many centuries. Like this, starting anything and making it reachable to huge number of people to get access is known as public facility. It's not only water that we consider as public facilities. All the basic requirements come under the category of public facilities, like electricity, public transport, schools, and colleges. When we talk about electricity, once the electricity is installed, once the electric poles were laid on the road, the wires were pulled, the electricity connection has been given to that wires which are running through that poles, and the connections are given to all, each and every household. You can use the electricity for running a fan, do some water supply to your fields through motors, to dig the water from the underground borewell using waters, or to supply water to the fields. Like this, various other activities can be done with electricity. You can light the lamps, you can charge your mobile phones, anything that can be. Once if there is no electricity, then you cannot do all these things. Like this, once it starts, it reaches to large number of people. Large number of people get access to it with the responsibility of the government is known as public facility. And public transport, if you want to travel from here to anywhere by your own transport, if it is a very short distance, you can travel by your own bicycle or your own motorbike. If you are traveling for a long distance, you have to travel by a car. If you want to travel by a car, you need to fill the petrol, you need to maintain everything properly in the car. And petrol nowadays is 70 to 80 rupees per liter. And if you are traveling for more distance, like 200 to 250 kilometers, for every 15 to 20 kilometers, you need to have 1 liter of petrol. Nearly 20 to 30 liters of petrol is required, which may cost you more than 3000 rupees only to fill the petrol. And then maintenance of the car and everything, another 500 to 1000 rupees extra for us. If you are traveling through the transport in which large number of people are traveling, if a bus which runs from this region to that region by the roads which are laid by the government and taken care by the government, then you need to spend only 250 to 300 rupees. Then you are saving more than 3000 rupees. Like this, when any facility is started, for an individual to go, it will be very costly and expensive. But if you are going with the public transport, it will be useful for you, flexible for you, and at very, very less cost when compared to an individual going separately there. Like this, we have public transport, which is very useful for the public run by the government. And we have many schools and colleges where nowadays in the modern societies, without education, humans are considered as wild animals. Because once you have educationally, you can have the knowledge to decide what is right and what is wrong. It doesn't mean that those who are uneducated are not human. They are also human, but having some kind of rigidity and old conservative type of thinking process. When you are educated, you have the concept of equality. You understand what is a right. You understand what is a law. You understand what is my limit. You can share your feelings without hurting others. You have your rights, but it doesn't mean that you hurt the others' sentiments. Like this, you understand all these when you go to a school. When you are educated in a college, you know how to interact in the society, how different groups of people live together and achieve the common goals of getting educated and finally getting somewhere placed in a company as a job employer or an employee. Like this, you have different roles to play. You get trained at the school, at the college level. School is a mini society where it goes a little bit larger when you grow, that is a college. Finally, you enter into the society where you have competition globally. So all these is the public facility which is available to the people where the government bears the cost. So now, what is a public facility? Public facility is something, once if it is started, it benefits to large number of people. For example, at a place where there is no drinking water, you go there, dig a borewell and lay a tap there and get ensured that supply of 24 hours of water there. You initially started, only one you started, but it will be benefited to thousands and thousands of people. So you are serving not the interest of one group or one family, but you are serving to thousands of people. This kind of nature of any activity is known as public facilities. And what is the role of the government? As I mentioned earlier, for everything, whenever we say public facility, we say that it is the responsibility of the government. From where does the government get the money to procure everything? Like, for example, you need water. The water has to be brought from somewhere where water is available in plenty. And from there, it has to be brought here. And it should not get any diseases in the middle. It has to be well pipelined, no fractures in the middle. Because if there is any opening in the middle, again, the water gets leaked. It is very difficult to control there. So the water supply has to be ensured. No leakages should be there. The water should be pure. Water should be purified and then sent to the places. And the tank should be there. The collection of the water should happen. Then from there, the water should be supplied to each and every household. So for laying all these things, the government need to spend hundreds and hundreds of crores on the departments which work for the water, the water works department. So the government has to pay for all these services. Nobody works freely for the government. And in the process of paying for the government, government makes everything in the pre-planned in the parliament by making a budget. In the next coming year, how the government want to improve the facilities, what are the plans that government has implementing, and how much it is going to spend, how it is going to spend, all these are detailedly discussed in the parliament when the budget session is discussed. Once the budget is approved in the parliament, the government gets the money and then it disposes to the various departments to ensure these facilities are provided to the people. You may get a doubt, sir, if I don't have drinking water or mineral water coming to me or pure water coming in my house, I can buy a water bottle which is available in the market. Yes, you can buy a water bottle which is available in the market, which we generally do when we are traveling from one place to another place, either in the bus stand, railway station or in the aerodromes. You pick up a water bottle of a branded company. These branded companies are private firms. They are earning profit by doing this. They are not doing any service to the society. They are actually earning, utilizing your need. They are giving benefit to you and they are earning some profit from that. You are in a position to buy that one. You are in a position to afford that cost, so you can buy it. What about the people those who are not in a position to buy that one, those who are not in a position to afford to it, you are able to get a good handsome salary, so you will be able to manage, buy it and get it. But what about the people, those who work for daily wage labor, those who work as house domestic maids? They are paid very less amount as salaries. So can these people be able to buy something for them, buy water for them? It is far from reality. Private firms are run on the profit motive. Government runs with the service motive. That is the fundamental difference. Private people work, turn huge profits. Government works to serve the needs of the society. That's what we call the role of the government is very crucial. And government is also empowered to collect taxes from the people and also charge a minimal amount from the people for whom they are providing the services and ensure to reach to large number of people. Like this, the government's role is really very crucial in ensuring public facilities reachable to many people. Water supply in Chennai, is it available to all? Is water available to all people in all corners in Chennai equally? As we discussed in the initial part of the lesson, providing public facility is the responsibility of the government. No doubt, water is a basic requirement and it has to be supplied to all with equal basis. No discrimination has to be made, and water is to be available in every corner of the city, village or any other place. But when we discuss about the real scenario in Chennai, you don't find like this. It is different. In Annanagar, you find the supply of water sufficient. When it comes to Saidapet, the 30 families struggle to get water in summer, even a bucket, at the cost of other family catching the water. So that is the real situation which is in Chennai. Moving in to understand how does the water supply in Chennai works. Same, the government is responsible to supply of water to them. Municipality meets half of the people's requirements of supply of water, and most of the classes who are been getting the effect of lack of water or shortage of water, here the categories are poor and the middle classes. These people only face difficulties in getting the water. The other sections of people or the other categories of people are easily able to get sufficient amount of water. Though the bore wells are not working, they are able to manage the tanker to get into their houses or into their towns or into their apartments. When it comes to the poor people's bastis or stalls, they have to wait in front of the canter or wait for the tankers to come 2 days once or 3 days once, and they fill 2 or 3 buckets of water for them and save it. So this was the time where we find what actually is happening in Chennai. But as per the Article 21 of the Indian Constitution, it is being given the right to life. When the right to life is mentioned in the Constitution, it guarantees all the conditions which ensures you to live happily. In this ensuring of to live happily, it is the utmost responsibility of the government to ensure all the conditions which are favorable for us to live in this region or this place. So getting sufficient and safe water is also the universal right of every human being who has been born on this planet. But in reality, in Chennai, you don't find it applicable. It is only the rich who are able to buy it, who are able to afford the cost, are able to get it. So what about the population who are working as daily wage laborers, who are paid very less amount for the work what they do from morning to evening? Will they be able to get access to safe and sufficient drinking water? The answer was no. It is very far from the universal right of getting safe and sufficient water for them. So, what is the next alternatives for this? In search of alternatives, the situation what we discussed about Chennai is not unique. This is a common scenario which we find in many number of cities in the summer months. Even in Hyderabad, even in Bengaluru, in Mumbai, you find these kind of situations in the summer months. So now, we need to search for alternatives. Actually, how much amount of water is required for the people per day? The Urban Water Works Commission has established certain facts for us. That is, 135 liters per person is required in the urban areas to fulfill his requirements. And it is only 20 liters that is reachable to the people in slum areas. 135, that is 7 times nearly more is available to the people in the urban areas who live in the good residential areas. When it comes to the people, those who live in slums, it is very difficult to get for them water. So only 20 liters is available to them. And it comes to the water usage by a single individual in a luxury hotel, that is 1600 liters of water is used by every individual in the hotels when they stay here. So actual requirement is 135 liters. It is nearly 15 times larger when it comes to the usage of water in the luxury hotels. So shortage of water is largely considered, especially shortage of the municipal water is looked as the failure of the government, because it is on the part of the government to ensure the basic facilities are reachable to the people. One of the suggestions which has been brought up or to look as an alternative was to hand over the supply of water to the private firms, so that some of the examples or in some places it has been proven that the government, where it has failed, the private organizations have proved that they can supply water and make it universally access. It happened in the city of Porto Alegre in Brazil, where the supply of water had been self-sufficient and there was no problem when it comes to the supply of water even to the far-off places within the city. So here it has been an example where when we hand over the supply of water to the private firms, there is a possibility to reduce the lapses on the government side and ensure 100% access to larger sections of people, even the downtrodden, below poverty line, or the people, those who stay in the slums also get access to water. But when we look at the other side of the coin, that is, the private firms generally work for profit motto. They generally raise the cost of the water. So there was a huge protest in Bolivia where the water supply was being handed over to a private company which has raised the cost of the water severely and made it very strict that everybody has to pay this much cost. Then the people have revolted against this and made a huge protest. So the government has to cancel that order, and government itself has taken the responsibility to supply the water. One side, we say that the private firms ensure 100% supply of water to the people where the government is not able to supply it or do it. While on the other side, we can take an example where the private firms have made a strict and rigid rules and increased the cost and made it not reachable to many people, for which people have raised a huge protest and forced the government to cancel that one. Now coming to in our country, in India, in Mumbai, in the recent years, the companies, the municipal corporations have decided to sell water to the hotels and all at little bit costlier than supplying water to them freely to the slum areas. So they started to generate some kind of income for the municipality, and now they are in a position to manage the revenue and supply water to larger parts of the city without any disturbance. So they have achieved success there. It is run by the government only, the municipal corporation only. And coming to Hyderabad, in Hyderabad also now we can see the considerable rise of the income of the municipal GHMC, where it has started to sell water to the private firms and supply water to the below poverty line people or slum area people, or supply the Manjira water to larger areas in the city. So here also we can see a positive growth. And in Chennai, where there is no possibility of availability of water, they decided to set up rain harvesting places and spots to identify the spots where heavy rains are there, and there they have dug the rain harvesting pits and store the rain water there to increase the underground water levels. So like that, we can plan and we can effectively upgrade and make the water reachable to the people. Supply of water, electricity, hospitality, education, healthcare, all these are part and parcel of the right to life, which has been guaranteed by the constitution of our country to all the citizens of the country. So it is the responsibility of the government to ensure that these all rights are reachable to the people, where people are able to get access to these facilities. It is not an alternative that handing over the government duty to the private firms will justify the solution of the problem, and saying that the private firms will charge some amount, so people should be ready to pay that amount and get access to this. No. Whether it is a government or the private firm, it should be mandatory that it should be made reachable to the people. Whether he is a rich person or a poor person, whether he lives in a luxury hotel or at a normal slum area, it is very, very important that the government has to ensure the supply of water, transport, education, health, all these facilities are reachable to the people. As it is in Chennai, though the government, the municipal corporation gives private companies the contracts, they fix the cost of the tanker and they fix the contract, so that government decides the price. That much price only has to be collected by the tankers who are serving privately. So the cost cannot be increased by the private firms. You maintain a recognizable control on that. You maintain a reasonable control over that, and there is no possibility for them to collect any kind of extra tax, so that the people would not feel overburdened with this. And ultimately, there is no compromise on giving access to universal rights. Whether it is a private firm, whether it is a government, it is the responsibility of the government to ensure that these all facilities are available to the people. But in reality, we find a great shortage to this. So the government has to take steps to ensure that all the individuals, all the citizens of the state get access to all the basic rights which are guaranteed by the constitution through the article 21 of right to life. This is what we have in public facilities.